Welcome back. Our guest who was born Okereke Blessed Jordan is a musician signed to 18th Record. He comes from a music and entertainment enthusiastic family. He started his career professionally last year after dropping She Don't Love Me and Message After the Beep, which received loads of positive reaction from people with zero promotion. Let's make welcome the man whose sound is heavily influenced by artists like The Weeknd, Jaden Smith and Travis Scott. Yadin.
Welcome, brother.
Welcome.
I'm good.
This is an interesting mix of inspiration. How do you do it?
My process is just easy. You know, I just make melodies with different sound, different aesthetic sound. Then I just, you know, just go with the flow and make it a fun process. And I just do what I do, you know, making music. It's not, I don't mean to make it a hard thing, you know, make it, you know, just flow easy. That's what I do with my music.
All right, so I listened to your track, Wild, and that's a wild song. Yeah, so tell us, what inspired the song?
Well, what actually inspired the song was I was about to be in a relationship. So the girl in question, she wasn't, you know, she needed that thing that I need to do for her to accept me. So, and I just wanted to dedicate the song to her, but, you know, the process of making the song.
She did not like peaceful guys like Eric.
In the process of making the song.
Yeah, you know, because I'm like this kind of labor person. Like, so she wanted someone that is out there. You know, she wanted grand gestures and that kind of person. So I just, you know, I just made the song for her. But before the song got released, my heart got broken. So
That wasn't wild enough then.
So okay. Are we going to have a wild part too? Like wilder?
Okay, I'm sure some people might not have heard Wild, so do you want to like do a hook on Wild real quickly before we carry on conversation?
Yeah. Girl, you make me wild. Anytime you smile. Baby, if you leave me, I will die. Girl, you make me wild. Me wild.
That's it. Okay. So what's it with this "when you leave me, I will die"? Because you're apparently still alive. So why do guys, you two, the question is for you two now. Why do guys always use that line? But I don't know. You are not dying.
Well, I think me, I'm more like his Daniel. If you leave, girl, I will swear for you.
So somebody
must die
in the process.
Okay.
So I believe you're going to be A-list, right? And then when you become A-list, what do you think will give you a run for your money in the industry presently?
Not really. I think I'm in my own, you know, in my own lane, per se. So I don't really think I'm, you know, in a competition with anybody. So I just want to be my own lane and do my own thing in my way.
Mm. But has anyone told you that you kind of sound like Rema? You have that Rema vibe. Have you been told?
Yeah, a lot of people have told me that. Yeah.
And how do you feel about that, not feeling like you don't have your own original sound?
I feel like, yeah, definitely comparison will come with every artist. Mm. So I feel like, you know, it's for me, I feel like it's a good thing in a way, you know, to sound like somebody good. So I guess I'll use it to my advantage, you know. So I will, you know, work, you know, better, you know, to bring that distinct sound. Because I feel like I'm distinct to an extent. It's just that we have that similar sound. You know, so, but I feel like definitely, you know, that comparison must always come up. You know, there must always be a comparison with every artist. So I'm not new to that. So I just get a ride with that wave.
Okay, so when did you decide music was it for you? And what were the things you had to put in place, or what did you have to go through before you got into this record label?
Well, I just felt like, you know, I just wanted to do music, so nothing really came up, honestly. I just wanted to do music, like, professionally last year, because last year was, like, a really wavy year for me, you know, a lot of things happened last year, so I wanted to, because I'm this kind of person, I don't know how to, like, put, you know, my emotions out there to people. I don't like, you know, saying things to people, so I feel like the only way I can put that emotion out there is to write. So I felt like when I started writing professionally, that was like in 2018. So I started writing, doing rap battles and stuff like that. So, and I feel like if I can use this to, you know, I can't really talk to someone like that, you know, to put my emotions out there, just playing. So I felt like writing is my thing. So I started writing and started putting melodies to, you know, putting how I feel and how I write. Then I just started listening to more of The Weeknd, because he has this ambient sound, puts me in a state of mind. So I felt like, definitely, this is my go-to guy. And, you know, looking at his stories and all that stuff, it gave me this motivation. So I just started, because I didn't have a studio, nothing. I didn't have anything at the time. And I just started doing it. I had to go get a mic, you know, and start writing music and start doing my thing and doing it my way. Then, I don't know, the call just pulled through and I got signed and things just kicked off from there.
What was the meeting point, sorry? Was this social media as well, or someone recommended you to your recording
label? The way social media is a really powerful tool. So I actually posted message after the beep. The video, I made it an aesthetic video. So not me in particular. So I just made a clips of different aesthetic videos, and it got to someone, and it got from like that. I just had to meet, and they really loved my sound. They went to my Instagram page at the time, and it was like, damn, they really need to sign this guy, and that just kicked up from there. So things were just going on from there.
So what's your relationship with your record label? Is it like I work for you guys, or we're a big family, and then you get some, you get to make decisions on your creativity, or you're just like, we want this particular sound, this is what we need you to put out there?
Oh, my label is like, we're just like families, you know? Yeah. It's like family is, you know, you just want to support you. You know, I've always, you know, being in a particular state in my life, when someone does something big for me, you know, I feel like, man, I have to pay back, you know. But for now I really felt, when I entered in Etienne's Records, I felt like this is just a family for me. I was new to it, and I've taken time to adjust, you know, but I felt like this is where I'm supposed to be.
Before we dwell too much on this bro and family thing, because we hear it and then after some time it becomes, no, they didn't treat me right. I hope you were able to go through your contract and you're fine with everything you have signed
with the lawyer
right now, and you're sure of what you've gotten yourself
your
into.
Your own lawyer.
How do you feel about your contract?
Yeah, my own lawyer. So the contract, I went through it, and my parents went through it, and they were like, okay, I should go through it again if I see if I was sure. So everything was just plain open, and they put it out to me, and I just saw it, and I saw it as an opportunity, you know. So I read it, and everything was like just cool.
Okay, so, great. So what do we expect from you going forward? What are you working on?
Yeah, a lot of, you know, trying different sounds, because I'm this kind of person that I don't want just for you to hear the lyrics alone. I want you to feel this certain emotion attached to the song. So for this while, you know, I wanted you to feel, you know, like you can go the extra mile, you can do stuff, you know, like you can go wild with, you know, go crazy with the sound. So, yeah, that's the kind of, you know, judged by the kind of artists I listen to, Travis Scott, The Weeknd. They have this, you don't listen to them and just listen to the music. Scott. Yeah, you just, you have this certain vibe with this ambience attached to it. So that's what I want to do with my sound, you know. I want to just take over
Astro World.
Yeah, so how soon are you dropping singles, EP, album?
Yeah, I will drop an EP very soon. Okay. Very soon. I'm very certain. There's work, a lot of work in ground, so I'm definitely sure.
All right, so there's something that always comes to my mind anytime I'm talking to musicians, because we know that education is also a very, very powerful tool, and you're still quite young, and I think the world is on your fingertips right now. You can actually school from just your phone and all that. So what's your plan for education? Are you going to further that, or are you going to be one of those stars that as soon as you blow, man, F school?
Now, I feel like education is a very interesting part for me, because I had fun going to school, because my mom was a teacher, so I have this, you know, this vibe for school. I don't like staying at home. I like going out to make friends and stuff like that. So I feel like I would definitely continue my education, but music is like that part that I prioritize more.
Okay, so music is primary for you, education is secondary.
Yeah, for me.
Okay, so now that you're trying to break into the industry, of course, you must have met some A-list artists, some A-list producers, try to have conversations. How would you rate that reception? And if there's one thing you have to change in the industry, what would that be?
Okay, definitely. But, you know, this time we're in this pandemic issue, so I feel like, you know, I've met a lot of people online, and I've worked with a lot of cinematographers and photographers too. So, what I'll try to change in the industry, you know, and I think I'm really changing it, is to everyone in my age bracket and more to just be who they are, you know. They should don't, there's, I feel like in this world, there are lots of rules that they use to control people. So I want people to have a mind of their own, you know, go crazy, go.
Go with, wild.
Yeah, exactly. Go wild. So with this upstairs, yeah, so you can use your brain to do unimaginable things. I don't want people to be like sheeps, you know. I just want them to do their own thing, their own way. So that's what I'll try to change in the industry. I don't want everybody to follow this particular sound. I want everybody to have this emotion attached to every song they listen to. Mm. Yeah. Mm.
All right, so another thing I saw was the lyric video to Wild, right? Yeah. Are we looking forward to a video anytime soon?
Definitely, definitely. Because I feel like there should be a video because it'll push the sound more. Mm-hmm. To give it this feel because, you know, people can hear, but what they see is actually what they hear. Visualize.
Being an upcoming artist, what has been your most challenging moment?
I don't really...
In the entertainment industry, yeah.
The challenge is, you know, to get people to, you know, see what you're doing.
To listen.
Mm. Yeah, to get people to see what you're doing. We're in an age where a lot of things can come and go. So you just need to, you know, try to catch the attention of people every time. And for some people, it's not easy to keep up with it. And I'm that kind of person. You know, that pressure, I don't need. I just like doing my thing my way. So that's what I'll try to change, you know, try to put my game up there.
Okay, good luck, Yadin. And you didn't get to tell us where that name came from.
Yeah, Yadin is actually the Hebrew meaning of Jordan. So, and it means the one who descends.
Okay, so, thank you for drinking tea with us. And that's how I wrap up this episode of Tea Time. You can send your opinions via WhatsApp to 0906005719. And definitely, all the messages we've gotten, we're seeing them and we say thank you for watching and please do keep them coming. Remember, you can also catch up on this episode and all exclusive content by visiting and subscribing to our YouTube channel, Plus TV Africa. My thank you, as always, to go to my co-anchor, Ifeoluwa Oshunkere.
Yes, sir.
And of course, our guest, Yadin. Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much.
My name is Elsie Godwin. Please do stay safe.